For me, the vow to be a nun was very strong. If I was young and I studied Buddhism, so I studied Buddhism for now 22 years, and I was very surprised from Buddha teaching. The time in my country was still communism, and I cannot get any spirituality. I was totally pressured from the government and from the communist idea. And what I start to learn, it was the yoga. And all the teaching from Hinduism. And if I get some material about the Buddhism and Buddha teaching, I was very surprised and very touched from Buddha teaching. So I feel in my heart it is something what I want to follow. And I try to give some contacts into Europe with some Sangha, with some nuns, but at the time it was impossible. It's not possible to be a bhikkhuni in Sri Lanka. The way of Silmata is totally different. And many bhikkhunis who also practice that, they have no idea about Buddha teaching. What I was pushing, what I still learn, it is to do a good puja, how to do with flowers, how to good sing and chant whole night. I was very tired for traveling every day to do puja, dana, make a good flowers, and have a nice voice for night chanting. After 3 years, I was very exhausted, and I tell myself, I deserve if I need to follow this way. And the time, the idea, what I hear all the time in Sri Lanka, I need to be a good nun, so I have possibility next life to be a bhikkhu. So I need to offer many, many presents for the bhikkhu and have a good merit to be a bhikkhu next life, so I can be enlightenment. It was for me impossible. I'm really standing now by myself, and I understand how important it is in your life to follow Vinaya. And have a clear understanding about the Vinaya, what I don't have. My teacher during the high ordination tell me, to be a bhikkhuni is not wearing the robe. And you understanding the Vinaya maybe after 12 years. But you need to try every day to be a better and better and to be a bhikkhuni. So I get it and I understand. To be a bhikkhuni is a long process. The feeling what I have uncomfortable now, all the time, it is not to put here something what is better and what is not more important to be a Silmata or to be a Samaneri. How I say it from the beginning, the Buddha established Bhikkhuni Sangha and I trusted the Buddha because he had the idea whom he want to ordain Bhikkhuni, not Samaneri or no Silmata. I never heard it about it. So I trust the Buddha. He know how he established and why he established the Bhikkhuni Sangha. So all the other ideas from the bhikkhus, from the monks, from the all others is not important for me. So I also want to tell you the discrimination what come in here is not from us. What you feel, it's come from the bhikkhu, what established now, Silmata, Samaneri, it is not from bhikkhuni. And I have the feeling in Sri Lanka every day, if bhikkhuni, Sangha will be getting destroyed, is for us and for the future no more possibility to be a bhikkhuni and rightly practice. If you can be a bhikkhuni, just do it. Because in the future maybe it's not possibility.